Yo, click the red subscribe button
and click the bell icon for notifications.
This is Tarak.
This is Alekhya.
Together
we are Tarak Stories.
Welcome back to Tarak Stories, guys. This is Tarak. And today we'll be seeing how to make a pizza at home. So how many of us eat pizza outside? I think most of us, right? But how many of us actually make that at home? I think very few. So why can't we make a pizza at home? It's not that hard. It can be made very simple. And I'm going to show you a simple version of making pizza at home. Let's go. Right, guys, now we're back in. So we will start the pizza from scratch. Alright, so I'm going to show you how to make a base as well. So the base can be made with or without yeast, but today I'm going to make one without yeast. And the best part about this is you do not need to leave the dough for a couple of hours for it to, you know, raise, basically, because there's no yeast in it. So I'll show you how a dough is made. Okay, now let's go here. Here I have a big plate in order to, you know, mix the dough. So this is like a 1 cup of all-purpose flour or maida. So let's put this here. Make sure to take a big plate, guys, that way, you know, it's easy to mix. Now, what are the ingredients that go inside? So this is about 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. So if you don't get baking soda, you can totally skip this and just do this with baking powder as well. I'm going to add about 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, some salt for taste. And we're going to mix this dough using yogurt or curd. So this is about 1/2 cup. So what we are going to do here is we are going to slowly start mixing all of this together and form this into a nice dough. Okay, now we have mixed this really well, so it's forming a soft dough. Now make sure to knead the dough, guys, because we'll have to make sure it's kneaded well. Now at this stage, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put about 1.5 tablespoons of oil. So any oil is okay. And start kneading once again. Okay, now this is done. So as I told you before, guys, we don't have to rest this, but let me quickly cut the veggies and some meat, and then, you know, I'll show you how a pizza is arranged. Now what I'm going to do quickly here is I'm going to take some of the dough. So let's just quickly grease this tray. Now you could use oil. I'm just using oil from the leftover. And what I'm going to do here is we'll go ahead and slowly start spreading this out. Now you need not use your hand, guys. You can use something like this, a rolling pin, just like how I'm doing. So you see how this is rolled. Now this is all spread evenly and it is nice and round. So what am I going to do is just adjust the sides. So you can make it however you want, guys. You can make a thick crust, a thin crust. It all depends on you. I somehow like thin crust over a thick crust, so I'm making it a little thin. You know what I do here is I'm going to quickly adjust the sides. So just do like this around the edges, and that way your crust will be really nice on the sides. Okay, now once after you've done this, what I'm going to do next is take a fork and start doing like this. So this will allow the pizza base, you know, to basically cook well on all sides, and also ensures that, you know, it is cooked evenly around. And this is a very important step, guys. Make sure you do this before you start applying anything on top of the space. So now that we have almost done, okay, now that looks perfect. Okay, now what am I going to do next? Okay, just a little to the sides. Now what I'm going to do next is, there are a couple of things that goes on top of a pizza. So first and foremost is a pizza sauce, or a base sauce they call it. So usually pizza sauce is made out of tomatoes, and it is available outside. You can buy that in a store, but if you want to make that at home as well, then do let me know in comment section and I'll make a video on how to make a pizza sauce as well. But today I'm just going to make it a little different. So I'm using Schezwan sauce as the base sauce because I wanted my pizza to be spicy today. But before I do that, there are different types of cheese that can go on a pizza. You can either use a pizza cheese spread, you can use mozzarella, you can use cheddar. But today I'm going to use two types of cheese. So I'll start off by applying some cheese spread. So this is basically cheese spread from Amul. So I'll just apply cheese spread at the bottom. Trust me guys, this method will make sure that the pizza is nice and crispy on the sides and at the bottom, and it's cooked evenly and the cheese really melts in your mouth. So I'm going to just quickly start applying the cheese spread. Okay, now let me put some, I'm using Schezwan sauce. So I'm going to use some Schezwan. If you are using Schezwan, make sure to put only a little because it can get quite spicy. So I'm going to quickly spread this on top of the cheese. If you want a traditional pizza that you buy outside, then you will have to use a pizza base sauce that's made out of tomatoes. Alright, now we have applied the cheese spread and the pizza Schezwan sauce on top. So I'm going to quickly start arranging the veggies. Again, as I told you before, you can use any choice of your veggies. I'm going to just put a little veggies here. Some green capsicum. There's no particular order. You can put however you like. Just be creative and make use of all different colors that you can find. So I'm just going to make it a loaded pizza. That's the way I like it. And okay, now what else is left? Okay, there we go. We have some chicken. I'm going to put some chicken. Okay, it already looks colorful. I'm just dying to eat soon as it's done. I hope it's mouth-watering to you as well. There's a lot of good stuff going in this, guys. Now, after we do this, so just make sure that the veggies are all firm. So I'm going to top this off with some mozzarella cheese. So I'm going to grate it. You can grate it or you can just cut into pieces, or anything works, guys. As I told you, there is no rule in what kind of cheese you put or what kind of toppings you put. Just be creative with it. Put the veggies you like. Add choice of your meat. But make sure you cook the meat before, at least 250% or more. That way, you know, it is not undercooked when the pizza is done. So the pizza takes not more than 7 to 8 minutes because I'm going to cook this at about 240 degrees, because since I'm using a grill oven today, the same goes with microwave as well, 240 degrees Celsius, and we'll cook it for about 7 to 8 minutes. Alright guys, so I just took the pizza out of the oven. It's been like, I've cooked it for about 7 or 8 minutes approximately. Now look at this, how nice it is. So the crust looks nice at the bottom, and if you see, it's completely cheesy and fully loaded, guys. This would be sufficient for 2 people. Now before it gets cold, what I'm going to do is quickly add some oregano as seasoning. So this way, what happens is it gets a nice flavor. So make sure to add any herb of your choice. You can have it as it is as well, but it would definitely make a difference if you add some herbs on top of this. Now along with the herbs, what am I gonna do is put some chili flakes. Now these two are like go-to for any pizza, right? And we can't miss them. Again, adjust according to your spice level. Voila, there you go. A non-veg loaded, cheesy and completely homemade from scratch. Alright, so I just cut through the pizza and I had a bite, guys. Trust me, it tastes really amazing. This is nothing short of a store-bought pizza, and I think this can be easily made at home. So hit me up in the comments and let me know what do you think of the recipe today. I hope you liked it. If you didn't like it, just tell us what you didn't like, and we'll see. We try to improve that as well. Now, this version I used a grill oven, as I told you before. We can use this, or we can basically do this on a microwave, or we can do this on a stove as well. So if you want to see any of those, just let me know in the comment section, and I'll make a video for that as well. So that's all, guys. That's been it, and I hope you enjoyed how to make a pizza from scratch at home. See you guys later. Bye bye. But wait, guys, have you guys even subscribed to our channel yet? Come on, guys. I think that's something that you could do, right? And it doesn't cost anything, right? It comes for free. So turn on the bell icon as well. Just get notified every time we put a new video. You know how amazing content we put, right? There are a lot more stuff coming up, and I'm sure you would be really excited to see all that. So go ahead, hit that subscribe button, and stay tuned for the next video. Bye, guys.